Well, I'm up next. I'm Darcy Wolfman. I'm section chief of GU at the AARP, so some of you have probably heard me speak before, but not on this topic. And I'm also, I do my clinical work at Hopkins Community Radiology. I have nothing to disclose. Okay, so we're going to talk about work-life balance. So I was responsible for putting this session together, so if you like these topics, thank you. If you don't, I'm sorry. But work-life balance, you know, your residents, then you're going to be fellows, and you're going to be staff. We have a lot going on. How do we do this all? So what work-life balance is not? It's not equal balance. Not all things in your life get equal time. It's also not stagnant. These things change week to week, month to month, year to year. Things change. You're going to be a resident, then you're going to be a fellow, then you're going to be a staff somewhere. You might get married, you might have kids, you might move to a new geographic place, you might pick up a new hobby. Your interests change, your life changes over time. One size doesn't fit all. So what defines a balanced life is really different for everybody. And this is something we're going to keep coming back to. You know, I wish I could stand up here and tell you here the three things you do and everyone will have a balanced life. But the truth is, it's different for everybody in this audience. What's important to someone sitting there is very different than what's important to me. And so a lot of this is just taking some time to figure out what is important to you and what works for you. So that was what it's not. Let's talk about what work-life balance is. So the first thing is, I really like to think of this as life balance because, you know, we're all physicians. Our work is a big part of our lives, whether we like it or not. So really consider work as part of your life. I think that's kind of, you know, when I did some reading about this to put this together, that's one of the first things they talk about is, if you enjoy your work, it's part of your life. So let's talk about life balance. So there's really no accepted universal definition of what life balance is, but a lot of places write about, and a lot of the business journals write about this, that it's achievement and enjoyment in life. Because we all want to achieve something and enjoy something. What that something is changes, but that's a pretty basic thing that most of us want. But you have to have both of these, right? You can't have achievement without enjoyment and enjoyment without achievement. So someone who achieves a lot but doesn't enjoy it, that's the hyper overachiever who is absolutely miserable. They're super hyper successful, but they're a miserable person to be around and they hate their life. So that's achievement without enjoyment. So you've got to have both parts of this. And this is both big and small things. Right? This isn't just the overarching, your whole life type things, but this is also really small things on a day-to-day basis as well. So you need to apply this on a daily, weekly, monthly, and yearly basis. Okay, so how do we do that? Well, there's three basic things, again, when I was kind of reading about this, that A, it's different for everybody. B, there's evolving priorities, so things change. And then C is time management. So, you know, it's different for everybody. You figure out what it is. Over time, you need to reevaluate those things and then see how do you fit this all in. So different for everybody. You have to prioritize what is important to you. And this goes back to, again, it's different for everybody. What's important to me is different than what's important to Nellie, than to Liz over there. Everybody has different priorities. And I encourage you to actually physically write it down. If you're struggling with life balance, think about what's important to you. If you have a spouse in your life, you might want to include them in that discussion too, because that's going to seriously influence what is important. You can't do everything. I'm sorry if I'm the first person to tell you this, that you can have it all. It's just not true. Madeleine Albright has one of my favorite quotes, and she said, you can have it all, just not at the same time. So you can do it all, just not right now. So you guys are residents or fellows, most of you. Radiology is a really big part of your life. If you've always wanted to travel the world for 3 months, that's not happening right now. Right? Those things are not exclusive. But you know what? In a bunch of years, that might be possible. There would be ways to make that happen. So you can have it all, but not right now. everybody has to make choices. Even the person you look at and you go, oh my God, I would love to get their job and live where they live and have their life. They've had to make choices too. Every single person has to make choices about what's important to them. Evolving priorities. So once you have this list of things, once you've thought about like what is important to you, you have to be really cognizant that that's not a stagnant list, that this evolves over time. You need to reevaluate what's working, what isn't. Maybe you thought something was important and now it turns out it's not so important, or life situation changes. People have kids. That's a really big evolving priority that you need to figure out how to work in. So things change over time. So even if you sit down and make a list, you have to be cognizant that it is not going to be set in stone. And then time management also needs to be active. So you need to actually be part of this and be cognizant of it and work to have time management. Okay. So it's different for everyone, evolving priorities and time management. So that's all really nice, but how does this actually work in real life? So I'm gonna use myself as an example and kind of go through what my life is and what some of my priorities are so you can see. I am not married and don't have kids, so I knew that some of you in the audience who might be married and might have kids would look at that and go, that's really cute, but no. So my friend Dr. Jamie Marco, who is a radiologist at NIH, is married and has two kids. His wife is an OBGYN and the program director at GW. So his life is very different than mine, and he graciously went through this whole exercise as well, and I'm going to use his as an example too. And you'll see, when you see his life and his priorities, if he can find time for some of the things he's doing, anyone can find time to enjoy the things that you want to enjoy. And you'll understand what I mean when I get into this. Okay, so what's important to me? Radiology is important to me, right? That's pretty obvious. I'm here speaking at Roentgen Ray on a Sunday, and I live in DC, and it's beautiful out. So radiology must be important to me. These are some of the things I do. I do all of these things because I achieve something and enjoy something, right? That should sound familiar. So I really enjoy radiology. I enjoy my job and all of these different activities in radiology. I enjoy for different reasons. My family is important to me. This is my family. I have five nieces and nephews, various pictures of them up there. I have my cat Max, my parents, and my family is very important. The Washington Nationals are important to me. Baseball. I love baseball and the Capitals. I don't know if there's any hockey fans, but lucky I didn't burst an aneurysm last night with yet another overtime game. I'm a big sports fan, so that's important to me. So again, there are people who hate baseball who would like rather gouge their eyes out than go to a baseball game. I love going to baseball games. Running and biking, that's me in the middle of a marathon. Drinking wine, if you're a marathon runner, Marathon de Medoc in Bordeaux, France, you can ask me about it later, it's amazing. But I run, I've recently gotten to cycling, so that's important to me. And traveling. I enjoy traveling. That's Portugal, Thailand, and Argentina over there. So I enjoy traveling. All right. So those are the things that's important to me. So like I said, I'm not married. I don't have kids. I knew I would put that list up, and some people will be like, yeah, right. Okay. So what's important to Jamie? So like I said, he is a radiologist. He works at NIH. He's the assistant chief of GU at the AARP. So he works with me at the AARP and lectures there. And he also does ACR ultrasound accreditation. This is Jamie's family and his wife, Katie, and his two little kids, Alex and Ian. So he is very busy with his family, and they're very important to him. Training, and Jamie actually like wrote these things. So training, Ironman and race across Minnesota. So he's done multiple Ironmans, and this past summer he did race across Minnesota, which is exactly what it sounds like. He rode his bike across the state of Minnesota. And he's doing all this in preparation to race across America. He wants to do this insane thing where you ride your bike across the entire country, which is insane. As you might imagine, this takes a lot of time, even just an Ironman. I hang out with these people too much. Even doing an Ironman is a tremendous amount of time. So the fact that he's got a family and does this, we'll go through how he does this, but this is not a small hobby he has. And he enjoys reading. He's in a book club. Gives him something to do with Katie, is what he said, and it gives his mind something to do outside of radiology. Okay, so those are the things that were important to me and important to Jamie. So evolving priorities, so how does that work? So that was what's important to me right now, but how has this changed and what did this look like when I was a resident? So just to kind of give you guys an idea of how these things do change over the time, when I was a resident, the goal of radiology was to learn radiology, and that's pretty much all I did. I wanted to pass the boards. It was a very big priority. It was a very time-consuming priority, but that was the goal. Family. So this changed in a very interesting way. I did my residency not in the Washington, D.C. area where my family is, and so holidays became a really important time for me to see everyone because I wasn't in driving distance. I couldn't see them just on a random weekend. Now my family lives really close. So although they've always been really important to me, how I organize my time with my family is very, very different now than it was when I was a resident. So that's something that changes over time. Before, holidays were really important to me because I was going home to see my family, and that was really the only time I got to see them. Sports, I am a season ticket holder for the Nationals and the Redskins, and yes, that means I have tickets to 82 baseball games. I do not go to them all. I go to a lot. We'll just leave it at that. When I was a resident, I've always loved sports. I grew up playing sports and watching sports, but when I was a resident, I went to a few games over 4 years. You know, we went to a few minor league games because one of the staff was a big baseball fan and he'd take us maybe once a year. Some of us would occasionally go to a Hornets game, but just a few games here and there because, again, there wasn't time, right? Learning radiology was that top priority for me then. I've always exercised. I actually didn't start running until a bunch of years ago. That's a totally different story, but I've always kind of kept in shape. Now I've been running and biking. I do something called the Sufferfest. You can look it up if you'd like to make your eyes bleed. Jamie and Katie are the ones who got me into it. So I do that, and I have whole training schedules now. And travel, I put that's funny because, right, when you're a resident, you have very limited time. And like I said, for me, when I was a resident, almost all of my vacation time and off time was spent going home to see my family. So I didn't get to travel very much like I wanted to when I was a resident because my vacation time was spent fulfilling a different priority. Now I'm lucky enough that I get to travel for one of my jobs, so I get to combine that, and I love to travel just to travel. So this was for Jamie, how things have changed, because he has two kids now. So his stuff changed for him too. So learn radiology, pass the boards. That's very similar to how it was for me, right? So he's expanded what he does in radiology. So when he was a resident, he didn't have kids. He said, he got married to Katie when they were residents, but his life didn't change very much because she was an OBGYN resident and they worked crazy hours. So he was still pretty much nothing changes. And then he had two kids, and he said his life exploded, was how he described it. So things are vastly different now that he has two kids. He actually played Division III basketball, so he continued to play basketball when he was a resident some, and now, as you saw, he has gotten into these ultra things and does ultra cycling and that sort of ultra, whatever you want to call those sports. Social life, so he used to go out with friends a lot. He did his residency in Chicago at Northwestern, so he would go out with his friends a lot. He went out with Katie a lot. He wrote this, so that is what he wrote for social life, was mac and cheese at home. And he said, maybe one day him and Katie will be able to go out to dinner again. But this is how things evolved, right? Family, two kids, something had to give there, right? Going out every Friday night to watch basketball games with his buddies wasn't going to cut it anymore with Alex and Eaton at home. So something had to give if he wanted to do the ultra cycling still. But that was a choice he made. That was what was important to him, was to do the training and spend time with his family. And then reading, he said when he was a resident, he only read for radiology. Now he listens to audiobooks to and from work and when he's on his trainer and reads books because he said he enjoys using that, a different part of his brain. So now that you have these priorities, and I hope you kind of see how this works, you know, this is what's important to me now. It's changed from when I was a resident. And so those are big global changes, right? That's over the course of years that these things happen, or some defined thing happens. I finished my fellowship and I got a job. But really, priorities change on a weekly, monthly, quarterly, and yearly basis. And I'm going to use my running schedule and exercise thing to kind of highlight this and kind of highlight how this works. So I have a weekly exercise schedule. So I actually physically have a schedule that's, you know, I'm going to work out these days, and I'll kind of show you that under time management. And then on the other end, I actually have a yearly schedule. So in December, I physically sit down and look and see what races I want to run, and then plan a running training program for the year around that. But then I got injured, and that whole thing went to crap. So I had to reevaluate what were my priorities. I can't run like I used to anymore. I had to take time off from running. So what was I going to do? I was going to miss one of the races. What did I want to do? So I started adding cycling. So that's something on a smaller scale, how you reevaluate these priorities. Life throws wrenches at you, and you've got to learn how to just roll with it and figure out, do I want to just stop running? Do I want to do something else? Do I want to just let this heal and try for a different race? Those are things that are going to come up in different ways, and you need to deal with them. So that brings us to time management. So I have the things that are important to me. I've figured out the priorities. I know that things are going to come up and you have to reevaluate them. So now I'm reevaluating them and I'm figuring out what's important. Okay, so how do we actually do this? Well, I use Google Calendar. This is actually my Google Calendar from, you can probably see the date, a few days ago. And I put everything on Google Calendar, so I know where I'm supposed to be and what's supposed to be going on. My clinical work schedule actually automatically syncs towards it. So this is at one end of the spectrum. This is what I do every week, which is like the lowest tech option you can have. It's literally a piece of paper that I write down my weekly schedule on. So I know what clinical rotation I'm supposed to be at because we cover 5 sites and I only work 3 days a week. And what other activities I have going on. I was in Chicago Friday night. And then I put in when I'm going to work out. When am I going to exercise? When am I going to run? When am I going to bike? Some of those can take more time than others. And I do this because then it's planned out for the week. So I know, okay, I know I do not feel like working out Monday because I am tired from work, but wow, is Friday going to be a nightmare if I don't work out today? So then you know. Then you don't get to Friday and go, I should have worked out on Monday. So I literally write it down. Now, this is what works for me. This probably will not work for the vast majority of the people in the room, but I've tried different things. This did not come about by me just poof trying this one day. I've tried all sorts of, there's like a million time management apps out there for your phones and computers, and I've tried a whole bunch of them, and this is what I stumbled on, what works for me. So I encourage you to try and see what works for you. But again, this has to be an active process. You can't just sit back and think everything's going to fall into place and you're going to have time to do all these things. You've got to look at your schedule and you've got to actively make time for the things that, again, are important to you. Other ways that I manage time. I have a cleaning service. Sounds like a little thing, but it saves me time to do other things that I enjoy. I struggle with that because I am very frugal by nature, so it kind of pains me that I pay for someone to do something that I can do myself. But on the other hand, again, I'm making a choice that I'd rather pay someone to do that and be able to go to the baseball game in the evening instead of cleaning my house. Amazon Prime is like the greatest thing ever because they will deliver literally anything that you need. Especially if you live in DC, that we have like Amazon Fresh and Amazon Now, so I can get something in like an hour. So Amazon is a big time saver for me as well. This is what works for Jamie, a really regimented schedule. Like I said, like he literally wrote this. He goes to work, he comes home, and he spends time with Katie and the kids. He works out, which you can imagine is not for like 20 minutes on an elliptical if you're training for an Ironman. He has dinner, he goes to sleep, and then he repeats the whole thing. He said he's tried all sorts of apps, he's tried all sorts of calendars and all sorts of stuff, But this is what works for him. What works for him is having a regimented schedule, and then he knows what he has to do. He told me, and I asked Katie also, so they know I'm talking about all this. Katie actually uses an old school paper calendar, like the really old like paper calendar things, because she's a really visual person. She wants to see it all out there. She realizes it's insane. She realizes it's heavy. She doesn't care. It's what works for her. So again, she's tried apps and other stuff too, but she came back to what works for her. So the point of this is you got to go trial and error. And even if everyone's saying, oh my God, it's the greatest app, you have to try it. Try it. If it doesn't work for you, then it's not working for you. And try something else. Weekly, he sits down with Katie and they plan out their week. So they have to figure out the nanny schedule and swimming lessons and when she's on call. So he has to make sure he's home for the nanny because she takes a lot of call. We chose our profession really well. They take a lot of call in OBGYN. So he had plans out the week with Katie again, so they know that they're on the same page for the week. Other things Jamie uses to manage time, they have a nanny, which shouldn't be surprising. They're both working full time. They have a lawn service. They have a laundry service, because what I didn't share with you is that Jamie does these things. Katie also does triathlons. So they have a lot of laundry from just life, kids, training, that sort of thing. And so he said, they're very frugal by nature as well, so it pains them to pay someone to do laundry, but the time they'd be spent doing all this laundry, now they can spend with their kids. So it's something you've got to figure out, how to make time in your life and what works for you. So in conclusion, life balance is really about finding things that you achieve and enjoy in life. And this is different for everyone. So I really hope that that's the take-home point here, is that life balance isn't going to happen if you're just sitting there and thinking, well, how can, you know, it's not going to just bowl you over. This is an active process. You've got to actively try to create life balance. And these priorities are going to evolve. You know, your residents now, or most of your residents, I know it's a ton of time. I was a resident, I'd like to think not that long ago. It was probably longer ago than I'd like to admit. But it takes a ton of time to be a resident. Your time, and here's the thing, when you're staff, that takes a ton of time too. It really does. It's just a different type of time, right? A lot of the stuff I do now, I'm able to do on my schedule rather than someone dictating my schedule. So I'm working on a Saturday most of the day, working on lectures, working on stuff for the AARP, so that I can go to a baseball game at 1 o'clock on a Wednesday. So I'm still working the same number of hours, I'm just able to shift them around. And so that's, you know, that'll happen to all of you also as you move on in your careers. And then finally, for time management, again, it's an active process, and you just have to figure out what works for you. And no app is one size fits all, and nothing's going to work for everybody. So thank you very much. The images have been of DC, so hopefully when you're here this week, you'll get out and get to see the city. It's a beautiful city. If you have any questions, I'm going to let Dr. Tan go, and then we'll answer questions at the end. And also, so I don't forget, I am... again, I was responsible for putting this session together, so please, I would love any feedback on what you liked, didn't like, ideas for future years for these resident symposiums, any of that would be greatly appreciated. And next up...